hoes try to stomach this thug life. They ring got the nose bandana on the grip. All heads coming out the foe. Connected from Cali to New York, nigga, so let it go. Made for this, nigga, I eat bars and drink flows. Thinking you woke into your third eye peephole. Line for line, this shit too easy, it's like a free throw. Mastered the game too early, this bitch a cheat code. It ain't a game, these niggas lame, state bring a shame. If I'm with an officer, it's a number in his name. We ain't the same, you want the easy pass, tell him change his lane. Shit, I've been through the fire, you can't stand the rain, take an aim. Tell him runner, he can try his best. Drive a car named after me, that's why I'm in the vet. Laughing these niggas once again, and I ain't break a sweat. Number one at everything I do, that's why I'm one West. The Lord is not the God of the dead, so when I die, coming back for my spot, so forever I'm top three. Just tell him to watch this, Canada with the mop stick. You gon' need a defensive lineman to block this. On point when I bomb shit, 10 for 10, I do not miss. I'm barking with a full bulldog, it is not mixed. They can see that my mind's sick, I don't write, I find shit. I don't like it, then I...
Preacher Captain, not desire to shout, no cowards, Virginia, ISUPK, Virginia, under command of General Yahama, the ISUPK. As you can see, here with another episode, this brand new season of the former of all days, the salt of the earth. And today, will we highlight all the Black, Hispanic, Native American inventions and inventors and things that have completely revolutionized society and the world as we know and see it today, and use and see these things on a daily life basis. And we have no idea where they come from. You understand how they came to be, all of these things. And God gave the world something. You understand? He made one people above. We're going to go to Deuteronomy chapter 7 and 6. These scriptures, like we always do, be sure to share these with your kids, share these with your children, share these, you understand, with your Black, Hispanic, Native American babies and families, so that everyone will know that when God says the former of all things, the salt of the earth, is not talking about all nations of people, all races of people, everybody on the planet. It is talking about God's chosen people, these 12 tribes of the nation of Israel, that no one wants to acknowledge are God's chosen people, so-called Blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, these 12 tribes you see listed here, man. Mexicans, Puerto Ricans, Cubans, Guatemalans, El Salvadorian, the natives and brothers from Central America, the Taínos, you understand, throughout the Caribbean, so-called West Indians, Indian Negroid descent, brothers and sisters down in Venezuela, Brazil, and Trinidad. You understand, down there, the descendants of the Aztec and the Inca and the Mayan, the Toltec Empire, and the Arawak Empire, and the Caribs, all of those, we are the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel before our oppressor changed our name and called us Jamaica and Puerto Rico and Cuba and Mexico. You understand, in El Salvador and Costa Rica and Dominican Republic and Trinidad and Haiti. You understand? So that's what we getting into today. The episode of Form of All Things, we're talking about a brother named Nathan Nearest Green. You understand? Nathan Nearest Green, that name may not be known to you. He was a slave born in Tennessee. You understand? The 1820s, this is this brother's name. This is absolutely criminal and a shame that the world does not know this brother's name, even though the world knows his inventions that he made. You understand? He was born a slave. He was born a slave in Tennessee around the 1820s, man, Nearest Green. They understand? He is the one that taught this man, Jack Daniels, the formula for that wonderful whiskey that the world knows, that Jack Daniels, that good hard liquor, that hard strong. He is the one that taught Jack Daniels. Everybody knows Jack Daniels. Jack Daniels sauce. If you ever been to Friday's, Jack Daniels whiskey, you understand all of the Jack Daniels flavors. But there is not without a father. You understand? You can't have sons. There's no sons without a father. And this brother right here is the father. You're the one that is the father of these Jack Daniels whiskey lines that you see here. He taught Jack Daniels his process on how to make whiskey, which revolutionized the entire, you understand, whiskey drinking world. Jack Daniels is a household name. Jack Daniels is a well-known name, a well-established brand, because of this brother here who was born a slave that worked and taught Jack Daniels how to make whiskey. You see him here in this factory working. Good old Jack Daniels. Good old Jack Daniels, all this fame and power and wealth and notoriety, and his brother, who's a slave, who's one of God's chosen people, gave him the idea of the century, of the decade, of a damn lifetime on how to make this whiskey. Now, of course, all throughout the Bible, we are known for brewing. We known for our different hard liquors and strongs and drinks and all the things that we make. Christ's first miracle was turning water into wine. The symbol for the tribe of Judah, one of the things to mark the tribe of Judah in the prophecies, which today we would call them stereotypes. It didn't have such a word in the back in the Bible days. They were known as prophecy. It said, Judah shall bind his ass, which is a donkey, to the choice vine. Choice vine, which is how you get grapes, how you get grapes to distill and make your wine, your spirits, your liquor. You understand? That has always been Israelite custom. It is not a sin to drink alcohol, to drink wine, to drink liquor, to drink strong alcohol. It is not a sin. You cannot be blackout drunk, peeing on yourself, trying to start fights. Then you should not drink, but it is not a sin. And there are many brothers and sisters who should not drink. You come into the ISUPK, a camp leader will tell you that you are a brother or sister who should never drink again. You understand? And that's what you should do for the betterment of your life, is to never drink again. You don't have to drink, but it is not a sin the way that the Christian church teaches. It is not unlawful. Christ drank, the disciples drank. You understand? It was customary to drink wine. It was an order to give a drink and a wine offering to the Most High with the sacrifice offerings of the lamb and the goats and the bulls, the blood offerings that the Lord required for the forgiveness of sins when we were under that old covenant. Now, thanks to Christ, as it explains in the book of Hebrews and as explained in the new covenant or the New Testament, the blood of bulls and goats could not clean us. That part of the covenant is over with the new one. There is no more animal or blood sacrifices. Of the animal sacrifice, because Christ was the perfect lamb, who was the last and only sacrifice the Lord will ever accept. You understand? Anymore. All right. So in Deuteronomy 7:6, when the Lord said, "But thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God," the God of this Bible is only for these people. The Lord thy God, thy is a possessive pronoun that shows ownership, meaning the God of this Bible belongs to these people, not all people, not everybody else on the planet, just these 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. Every other nation and race of people has their own gods. Go ask the Chinese about their gods. Ask the Arabs, ask the East Indians about Vishnu and Brahma and Shiva and all of the gods that they have. You understand? Go ask the Arabs about their God. Their God is Allah, that rock they circle in the Middle East. That's why they pray to the East. You understand? To Mecca. Their God is not the God of this Bible. Our oppressor made up his own God, a white image of himself that he forced the world to worship as God, claiming that as Jesus, when it's really Caesar Borgia, a member of a notorious crime family throughout Europe, known as the Borgias. HBO has a mini series on it. It's up to 3 episodes now. You can even see that on Netflix. A whole crime syndicate known as the Borgias. That man murdered his father. Rodrigo Borgia had sex with his sister, Lucrezia Borgia, the homosexual lover of Leonardo da Vinci. That white image of Jesus Christ that abuela, your mama and grandmama, and every Christian, when you close your eyes and bow your heads and pray to, that's who you're praying to. That's the spirit that's on our people, and that is why our people are destroyed and do not understand our heritage that God gave us in the Bible. You understand? For thou art a holy people, a special people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God have chosen thee. That's why this brother who's a slave, living a slave's life in Tennessee, he is one of God's chosen people. Joseph was a slave in Egypt. He became second in charge of all of Egypt. You understand? Right out of the slave pits. Well, this is a brother who was born a slave, and he created and taught Jack Daniels how to make whiskey. Now there's a Jack Daniels distillery, all of these Jack Daniels lines and flavors. That process came from this slave, Nathan Nearest Green. All that Jack Daniels wealth, all of that Jack Daniels money, years later, there's a brand called Uncle Nearest, named after him, because, of course,
after his technique that he taught to Jack Daniels, the white man who is not a slave, who does not come from slaves, he has the tools and resources to get a whole factory and everything running. And his brother, who comes up with the idea to make him billions for that Jack Daniels family, well, this brother just gets to work in the factory amongst all the other white men who don't know how to make this life revolutionizing whiskey to go all across the world. They won't teach you this in school. You won't learn this in Black History Month. You won't learn this in your HBCUs. You're not going to learn this going to church, being a Muslim, being a Christian. You're not going to learn these things because they don't want to teach you about race. They don't want to teach you about God making all people separate. They want to feed you this lie and this narrative so that you'll stay asleep while every other nation of people moves into your neighborhood and your community and gets wealth and power and feeds off of your inventions while we just so happy to be included. Just so happy they saying our name. Just happy to dance and sing because that's all the church taught us. To dance and sing, the School of Performing Arts, never what is actually written in the Bible so that we can go forth and conquer and be holy unto the Lord our God. The Lord thy God has chosen me to be a special people unto himself above all people, not equal to, not the same as, not 50-50, not everyone is equal, above all people on the face of the earth. That is how a slave is able to make this Jack Daniels whiskey, and then Jack Daniels gets a whole company and a line out of his technique that he learned from some brother slave. His name was Nathan Green. They called him Nearest Green. It's him working in the factory. This is him with Jack Daniels, some oppressor getting rich off of this brother. Now, if he wasn't a slave, Jack Daniels would have never learned his customs. He would have never had to work for Jack Daniels in his factory. He would have his own factory where he'd hire his own people, and the billions of dollars in wealth made from the whiskey that Nathan Green created, Jack Daniels would never have that money. They'd be drinking on swill and bootleg, whatever they could produce, unless they had us to exploit, to feed off of in our destroyed state. This is why the Lord told us in Deuteronomy chapter 7:3, he said, neither shall thou make marriages with them. Thy daughter thou shalt not give unto his son, nor his daughter shalt thou take unto thy son. The Lord told us never to join another nation of people. Don't have interracial marriages. Don't have sex with their people. Don't take their gods. Don't take their cultures. That's how we ended up in slavery. This is how a black man named Nathan Green created this. All of his inventions and power goes to this rich white man so that he can get rich. And you just eventually, people will find out that Jack Daniels whiskey was a product of a brother who's in slavery that taught Jack Daniels, you understand, his formula. For they will turn away thy son from following me that they may serve other gods. And we serve other gods, the gods of the Africans and the Arabs and the sky god and burning sage and consult crystals and praying to the damn zodiac. Meanwhile, all of these other races of people, they're able to now exploit us because we are destroyed and we go into slavery. That's how the East Indians got rich. British set them over their plantations because the West Indians and the natives all throughout the Caribbean, we were in slavery for disobeying our God. The same way that Nathan Green was in slavery, which is how Jack Daniels was able to learn his technique, set up tours, set up breweries, distilleries, all of these things. This is why the Lord told us, don't join another nation of people. Jack Daniels, all of his wealth, all of his power. Meanwhile, he would be nothing without the slave that taught him. This is the brother here. So when the Bible says, ye are the former of all things, you're the creator, the father of all things. That's why we have this series. You understand? He's talking about Jeremiah chapter 10 and verse 16. Ye are the former. The portion of Jacob is not like them, for he is the former, the creator, the father of all things, and Israel is the rod of his inheritance. Israel is a man. His name was Jacob. His name was changed to Israel. That man had 12 sons. Today, those sons are the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel, and that is God's chosen people. We reproduce God's people on the earth. so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native American men, because the father carries the seed. We reproduce God's people on the earth. Everybody is not God's people. Everybody is not the children of God. The only reason anyone thinks that is because we went into slavery and they stole our records and made money just like they stole us and sold us, selling our records, which is known as the Bible today, or the Bible and the Apocrypha, if you get a Bible that's after 1611, because they started to butcher up the Bible and make stories, you understand, and change word and take things out so they can hide the true identity of who the people of the Bible are, which are so-called Blacks, Hispanics, Native American Indians. Matthew 5 and 13, it says, ye are the salt of the earth. This brother who was a slave did not grow up with the best conditions. He lived a slave's life down in Tennessee. But even though and through all of that, he still was able to make his revolutionary world-changing recipe so that Jack Daniel's whiskey could go worldwide and be known full of wealth and power, which is what the Lord warned us would happen if we disobeyed him. We went into slavery. All of our inventions, another nation of people has it all. Since ye are the salt of the earth, we are the creators, the ones that give this earth its flavor, its power, its ability, its inventions. Everything that makes the world wonderful comes from these 12 tribes of the nation of Israel, brothers just like this. Nathan Green, you look at this picture, you think he's just another one of the workers in the factory. Meanwhile, the only reason that there's a factory and a product to sell is because of this brother. All these white men have jobs and careers to feed their family, to feed their cities and their towns, because this brother is in slavery because his people disobeyed their God. That's the only reason this company exists. But if the salt have lost its savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is henceforth good for nothing to be cast out and be trodden under the foot of men. Ye are the light of the world. We give the world as light. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. You can hide us all we want. That's why they hide us in prison holes, prisons and ghettos, and barrios and reservations and cotton fields and slave pits, hole in the walls, favelas and shanty towns all throughout the Western world. Everywhere on the planet, we are hidden in prison houses, forgotten about on the other side of tracks, the bad side of town, the least desirable real estate until they destroy it for decades. Then they want to come and turn it into an investment property. That's talking about these 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. But even still, in our destroyed state, we shine so much that you can't help. That's why they had, you can't help but recognize us. That's why they had to flood our communities with drugs and get Planned Parenthood to tell sisters to murder their babies with abortions and get preachers to tell us to have smaller and smaller families to be more American, more like white people, to give them a chance to catch up, because every race of people is in competition except the one that thinks that they're on everybody's goddamn team following behind these silly preachers like Martin Luther King. This has been another episode of The Form of All Things, The Salt of the Earth. This brother here, Nathan Nearest Green, the creator, father of the Jack Daniel's whiskey that everybody knows about. This is him right here, Nathan Green. Like, share, subscribe, tune in to another episode. Brand new season of The Form of All Things, Israelite School of Universal Practical Knowledge. Nathan Nearest Green. With that, shalom.
You want no cowards in a get, in a get.